going to start with my little story about the mouse in the house. Now, I'm going to preface it by telling you I have three kids. I have a now 7-year-old, a 14-year-old, and an 18-year-old. So I got two teenagers, so there's a lot of stress just for that fact alone. But my middle child, my only daughter, is the one that was diagnosed back in 2010 with severe OCD. And I use the word severe, and it's a mild way of really putting what was really happening, and we'll talk about that. So I have a daughter with OCD. My 18-year-old is on the spectrum of Asperger's. I think it's now called autism, but it's on that spectrum. But he's functional, social and all that, but he's on that spectrum. So oil, water, don't mix. Okay, so just to let you know, that's where this thing started. So anyway, what had happened in our house is we had a little field mouse get into the house, which we've had before. I mean, we've had all kinds of creatures come into our house, and it's not the best sealed-up house in the world. But this little mouse just happened to elude me. Now, we have those little safe traps that you put in. You capture them, you take them out, put them out into a field somewhere. This one eluded me. And I actually thought it had climbed up in the back of the stove because our cat focused on that daily, waiting for that mouse any time. So I thought it had climbed up, and then later on I actually thought we kind of cooked it at one point, but I don't remember that. But so I did not tell my youngest. Now this is about this is 2012, somewhere around there. It's about 4 years ago. And my youngest was about 2. My daughter was probably about 10. And my oldest was about 14. I hadn't told the youngest one and my daughter, because with OCD, you've got to know the right moment, time, and procedure and how to tell them anything like that. So I hadn't mentioned it to them. Somewhere in my crazy mind, I decided to tell my oldest son, which is probably my biggest mistake. But so yeah, I had told him about it, that I had gotten into the stove. Well, all right, so this night in particular, it's about 9 o'clock, and now with my household at that time and even before, getting through a day without an explosion, without a reaction, without a burst of yeah, coming from my daughter was a miracle. So I was looking at 9 o'clock and thinking, we're almost there. We're going to make it to bed tonight without anything happening until my son came down. Dad, whatever happened to that mouse that got up in the stove? I'm like, No, don't say that, you know. You're trying to stop them, but you can't, you know. My daughter, the rocket started to ignite. Yeah. Mouse? There's a mouse in the house? Where's the mouse in the house? My littlest one decided to make it into a little song as he danced around his sister going, a mouse in the house, a big old mouse in the house. And my daughter's smiling white, all while my son is going, but Dad, you don't understand. You know, and I'm trying to shut him up. Please, they'll talk about this later. We can talk, you and I, in the room, whatever. No way that's going to happen. Now, what made it worse? Dad, you don't understand. That mouse could chew through the wires and cause a... Okay, now, at this point, don't you want to be able to go, no, and stop the words and throw them back up into his mouth? You can't do that, because the next word was fire. And my daughter was like a bottle rocket. Fire! Oh my God, there's going to be a fire! Because the stove was right behind her as it was, so, you know. And of course, the little one, mouse in the house with a big old fire, you know. I couldn't shut him up for my life, depending on it. You know, I was getting to the point of saying, shut the eating up. And I didn't want to do that. We don't use that kind of language. Well, not when the kids are out. My wife heard this going on, and of course she knows the emergency signals when my daughter rockets off. And she comes down the steps and says, what's going on? I said, get him out of here now. You know, so she grabs him by the shoulder and back upstairs, but the whole time it's, but Dad, you don't understand, the mouse and the fire. You know, 20 to 30 minutes just to get her off the roof or off the ceiling. And then the rest of the night is really chaotic. You know, not hard to go to bed, hard to get a mind off of it, harder to get, you know, I think you might know that story. You've ever dealt with somebody with OCD before. Now, I tell you that story, and it's a funny story, and it's funny now, and it probably wasn't quite that funny at the time. But that wasn't the worst of it. That was 2 years into it, and my daughter was on a better place then. She had been through therapy, she had been to work. 2 years before that, we were dealing with violence, anger, anxiety, nights of clawing, scratching, kicking, screaming, destroying things. The hurricane bathroom, I used to call it. And she would spend 2 to 4 hours washing hands, detail by detail by detail. And it's that kind of disruptive.